parked out. I got 3880 holding out to him. Well, I'm usually saying. We got a big old problem here this morning. I'm a new project we own. Got through with the tile, but I'll show y'all the final shot after a while. I ain't got the plug covers on yet. That's all I like. But this is what we're up against now. Got a bad U-joint on my bush hog shaft. Let me show you the whole shaft. So there's the whole shaft. This thing's all right. I'm probably not going to change it, but I might. Just according to what they cost. This one has had it. Anybody that's ever messed with anything like this, realize it. See how to just wobble. See there? See that wobble right there? That's wobbling. That's not supposed to do that. It's just about gone. And the huge problem is this right here. Y'all see that? Somebody has beat this down. See how it's beat all flat on the back side right there? See how it's beat down flat? That's not going to allow the new joint to go in. I am going to really have a booger getting this. The owner before me did that. Believe me, I got better sense than to take a hammer and beat that damn flat. That was so stupid. Unbelievable. Anybody. That was one ignorant man that did that. Got to get this key out right here. Broke. They beat it till it broke. Pretty easy doing that. That has got to be heated up, straightened back, best I can get it. What I'm gonna do is take it loose here. This one ain't bent. Hopefully, I may break this one too. I may have to buy some new keys. Spring lock. I don't know really what they call these things. But I've been dealing with them all my life. My daddy was a mechanic. Yeah, I broke it. So thing's probably the one that come in there. I bought that bush hog. You use it. The whole gearbox had a broke gear in it. I got it thinking, you know, that won't be no big deal to fix. that gear to go in there was $100 used. It's turned out good though. Let me get some pliers. It's been in there ever since. I've had the bush hog now. Been using it about 20 years. And I know this was going to be a booger when I went to do it. That's the only reason I ain't done change it. Oh, that's in there good. See if I can get a little slack. That's probably another thing. Thing been in there so long, I mean, I never get them to move. That key sure don't want to come out. I call it a key. Spring lock. I really don't know what they call that. I never have. I replaced a bunch of these joints. don't usually have to replace this part. This spring lock usually comes right out. You don't have to replace it. Everything seems like I do these days is just absolute worst it possibly could be. Let that one soak a little bit. And that one too. Boy, that one just rusted all the pieces right there. Man, I may not get these things out. Gonna be a booger. Usually what the hard time you have with it is spinning in there. They make a special pliers for this. It squeezes it right there, but I don't have them. Never have had them. All you're supposed to have to do is squeeze it together like this and just pull it right out. So I got it moving on that one side right there. That's good. It's supposed to just spin in there instead of breaking. Supposed to be able to just spin it round and round. Boy, that thing's in there on that side. Somebody probably beat that too. Cup supposed to move back and forth a little bit. There's grease on my arm there. And it's sore. Can't touch none of this mess without getting covered in grease. Because that's why the other end is doing good as it is. And that's why this one's lasted as long as it has, because I've kept it greased. Man, it had it before me. Don't look like he did nothing to it but use it. So it was jumped out, yeah. It was sitting in the man's junk pile when I got it. I think I see it moving a little bit over there. Well, I do, but not the part I want. That part over there, buddy, it's rusted shit. Rusted good. Oh man, this is killing my back. That tile that I did. There you go, I got it spinning. If I can get it spin around to the other side, I can't half see it. It won't lay flat like it's supposed to. Because it's thing on the end of it here. Yeah. Aggravating. Oh. Get it spin around to this side, it might come out easier. For sure it will. All it can do is roll over. Yeah. All right. Got one of them. Two of them. Got to get all four of them. Gonna have to be a two-part video for sure here. Gonna be a job. Like everything. That's spinning. That's what it's supposed to do. You get it spinning like that, you know you got it loose, it should pop right on out. get all that dirt and grimes out of there by spinning it. Yeah, see it spinning around. Get one doing that. Should come out when you mash it then, like, yeah, see that's trying to come out of there like it's supposed to. Just keep a hold to it. Like I said, they make some special pliers for this. If I don't have them and never have had them, I sure will need to buy a pliar. Let me try my needle nose. Fit up in there better, maybe hold on better. Look at there, same problem. Come on out of there, dude. Just so much gunk. There it went. That's the way she's supposed to come out, y'all. I got another one right here, scrolls up. Got to get it spinning. Gotta roll around there and get off the camera so y'all can't see nothing. Anything on that other end there is just torturing me. I'm gonna have to pull it all the way out, I guess, to get rid of it. Come on out of there. Got it? Jump out of there now that I got it moving. All right, first step, got them all out. Now I gotta find a socket that'll fit that. Pray I can knock it out. Piece of oak right here. It better work. They'll see. By the way, this is called a universal joint. And this whole thing is called a drive line, drive shaft, some people call it. This is a drive line off of Bush Hog. I was afraid to try to run it any longer. I'm gonna go from both sides to try to get it loosened up. Should be able to knock it out of one side. Maybe socket may still be too big. I think I felt that one moving just a little. Don't want to break it. Beat it so hard that you break this shag. Yeah, that's going down in there. I hope y'all can hear me. You can't stay out here without the fan running.
Keep vibrating around. Turning on too.
There's something to keep clicking on that thing. Just put a new motor on it. What that is, it keeps clicking like that. There ain't nothing wrong with that motor. I may have to let this thing soak a little while on DW. I may have to. It's moving. Hallelujah. May have to. Torch it. Get it off. Hope not. Ain't good torching metal. Loses some of the strength when you heat it up.
Alright.
Why in the world I hadn't done did that? Got rid of that other end that keeps on not letting it. Yeah, it's moving. Keeps on not letting it move or lay flat. Got rid of that. The one I hadn't already thought of. It slips out. Y'all see what I'm doing? No. Put my hand right in the way. Ain't no way around that. I'm gonna have to. Zoomed in. No, it ain't zoomed in. We'll put some hard licks on that baby. Supposed to be down far enough that knock this one out. That ain't going right. This one should be out. Like I done belly it out. Yeah, that's rubber seal. Yeah, I can see a crack right there. It's almost out. Just pure out dirt and stuff. Build up on it. Try one more lid. See if I can get some vice grips on that and get it to spin. Saying, but I can't stand it out here without a fan. Oh man, we're in last part of July here. It's about 100% humidity. Getting up to 98 during the day. Right there. See, that thing is full of little roller bearings. Now these right here, they in good shape on this one. See little pin bearings in there. That's in good shape. It's the other side that's messed up. I took one of these out. I think you got to go back that way with this one to get it out. I don't mess up my sock. Wish I had an old one. Yeah, it's going back. Still in good shape, but when you have to replace it, you have to replace it, the whole U-joint, see? Now they come apart, yeah. This part is in pretty good shape. Ow, just cut my finger. That nothing but dirt, caked up dirt grease. This part, thank goodness, I won't have to. Free, I can fix this because this is expensive part of it. See, that's got a, that's what locks it on. See that in there? That locks it on to the PTO of the tractor. It'll be a mess. It's going to be expensive to replace that. Expensive. I got to get something thinner now. Put it in my vise and try to straighten this out. I won't never get it out of there with that bent like that. Never. It's already started moving, I can tell that. See that down right there? I got to get this beat back out. So, get over in the vise. We'll move y'all over there. Fan over here. I'm gonna have to move the fan. Getting enough air over here. Enough light either. I'll try to get more light on right here. help any? Not much. Let's try this one. I put light on the subject, also burned me up. Hot. It's one of them halogen hot lights there. Do this, but I'm gonna try it like this first. See, it's just backwards from what it needs to be. The shaft would help hold it in there if I could. If it needed beating this way, but you can force it's not ever gonna be easy. Deer stand step. I kept one of them for a bunch. I got them in trees all around this country. Using them for deer stand steps. Man, give me a bunch of them. That actually shouldn't be that hard to bend back, but just get it. Hell, I gotta get it somehow. Hold it. Problem. Holding it steady. I'm going to get some pressure on it. What do you think about that old chisel? Look at that. I bet you that is old. It's got a leather wrap on it for a handle. It's actually broke. It comes in handy sometimes, stuff just like this. Y'all see what I'm doing? Hit it right there like that. See it turning, twisting in it. Fire. I knew that was going to be the problem. It's so hard to hold something like this. Now I've been doing this kind of stuff right here all my life. I should be a pro at it, though. I don't think nobody ever gets to be a pro at this. You just have to do it by the seat of your pants. Do whatever you have to do to get the job done. And you always got fate working against you, or devil, or whatever it is. I may be making it worse. All right, y'all. I heated it a little while now. Let's see. See if we can do anything with it. We'll try it like this first. That's what I'm telling you about it. This ain't no way. The whole universe works against you when you're trying to do something like this. Trying to Jesus.
Ow. Hmm. Never heard that. My finger.
See the cap moving around in there. Easy, but let's see it. Just get it hot enough. I know it would.
Got it pretty close.
Believe it or not, that straightened it out a little bit. It's hard to tell, but it definitely straightened out a little bit. I might know there'd be a shadow right there where I'm. Not enough. Come on, come on, come on, get hot. Turn that torch up, it'll blow out. Even if I had some map gas, it'd be better than this. I gotta get me some map gas bottles. I need a torch. Doing this kind of work, you know, like I've been doing all my life, you need a torch. I told my wife that many times, but she don't seem to agree. Another 1/16 of an inch. Best I can see. Got it moving though. Bad is the other side got to be done too. I don't know if I could get it all to come out this way. It wouldn't. Can't do that. You saw how I had to do that other one. That's how I have to do this one too. time getting that key to lock back in. That's the reason I was using this. Hoping I could knock that groove back in it like it's supposed to be. I'm gonna have to cut that groove back in it for sure. See if we can knock it out some now while it's good and hot. Jesus is with us. That's what it is. Good Lord blessed us. Got that side. Man, hard part. Yeah, that's messed up a little bit right there. I'm going to have to try to straighten it. Maybe cut a little of it off. This chisel. Thing to hold. that metal just like you can wood. You got a good hard chisel. Thank you, Jesus. Look at that. is that Jesus will never let you down. All you have to do is believe. He says that plain as day in the Bible. He says, if he that believeth in me shall never die, have eternal life. I believe that. When he done his healing in the Bible, he asked the people almost every time, he said, do you believe that I can do this? A woman, she said, I want to believe. That's all she said. And her child was healed. Another soldier, Roman soldier, came and asked him to help it to heal his slave. He was about to die. He was so sick. Jesus said, okay, show him to me. Started moving that way, and then Roman soldier said, no, I'm not worthy. I'm not worthy for you to go to my house. Just say the word, and it'll be done. And Jesus told the people, said, in all of Jerusalem, there's no faith like this man here had. He said, so be it. The man went home, and by the time he got home, the boy was up out of bed. And he asked him, what time, something to this effect, what time did it happen? They told him, and it matched it, the time perfect, that Jesus said, so be it. And Jesus will help you with stuff like this too. I'm a witness to that. Y'all are too now, you just seen what happened. This is something right here that, man, it's bending metal with a tiny little bit of heat. I'm telling you, see how that thing is beat down? There ain't no way in the world that would come out of there, especially this one. If I hadn't have heated it and beat it back with this one. And I don't think it would have ever come out of there anyhow if it hadn't been for Jesus' blessing. I'm going to have to take my little drywall router with a diamond bit and grind me a new track in there on both sides. And I think I'll have it. All right. There you go. How to take a universal joint apart on a drive line. And I'll show you in a little while how to put it back together. All right. Big R. 3880, over and out. God bless. In Jesus' name I pray for you. Amen.